And the modification is the fact that versus the full decker over there, which has round bars up here, the modified decker, you can see they've tried to put some shoulders on it to actually, so that it would do both what a sawbuck saddle would and a decker saddle. You could use panniers that have straps that you could loop over, and they wouldn't roll back over the decker. Whereas that one, you can see where they just roll over pretty easy and so forth. So the modified specifics to, the style of packing that you do on all of them. Like I say, this was to try and combine everything. Just like in most things, nothing that you try to combine is usually as good as the things itself, but it can be used. And you can use a decker with your panniers and your bags, and you can use a sawbuck with sling ropes. A decker style uses sling ropes, and this is your sling rope right here, and it uses two basic hitches, two basic slings in order to do it. Like I say, if we want to go through adjustment, I kind of left some of them purposely to where they aren't adjusted, so forth, right? So if you want to go through that, if anybody needs hands-on experience there, that we can actually adjust the pack saddle to the animal. The decker system is used more into the north of this particular country. We're kind of the dividing line, the Utah-Idaho border of, as to packing styles. The southwest was sold on sawbucks and that style of packing using boxes and panniers. Hey, knock it off. The deckers are used more in the north country with the mining and different things, because they were hauling a lot of different odd size equipment and so forth, so they developed a system that worked for them. The advantage of a decker saddle, the only real advantage, is the fact that you have adjustable rigging on them, to where if I need to move my cinch because I sore up here in the armpit, if you will, or I can move that cinch back and make it a different position on my cinch. That's the big advantage for them. As far as where your rigging should come off, this saddle's pretty much right. You use a half breed on them, which is just a canvas cover with a board that's inserted to it. General rule on them, that board is there to protect, because again, you're not, in sawbucks you're gonna use boxes or panniers and so forth, aren't gonna put a lot of pressure. Here we might be packing a wheelbarrow, a ton of trail equipment such as Pulaski's, shovels, picks, and different things. So that there is simply to protect the side of the animal from the rigid things that you might have in a barrel sling and so forth. Your rigging should come down, and your ring should rest right there on that saddle. The one disadvantage of that is then it kind of can prevent you from tightening up your cinch, and you've got to watch that. Other than that, there's a breast collar and a britching, which is standard. That's really the only difference, or the only advantage. The advantage is if you are slinging, that the round bars on a decker allow for your ropes to slide a lot easier than the wood sawbucks. On a standard riding saddle, we can take the sling ropes, using your saddle horn as a front ring, and you can use your cannel as a back ring. You can actually go ahead, come up here, run through your gullet, and we can do any sling off of a riding saddle that you can do off of a deck or pack saddle, or vice versa. You can actually hang bags like you would on a sawbuck. So you can do it all with a riding saddle. The difference is a nice pack saddle is probably in the $400 range, a nice riding saddle is probably in the $1,200 range. You're gonna do some damage to your leather and different things. So if you're gonna use it, that's why saddle panniers were invented. It's because they're just bags that are developed to go over your saddle and protect your saddle. So I wouldn't recommend trying to use it as a pack saddle.
How come just a single clinch? Like on the sawbuck, you got two. How come on the decker you only have one?
I really don't know. I can tell you why you go to the double cinch on a sawbuck. They're trying to distribute the weight, the pressure, over a wider surface.